Zombie apocalypse.
Okay, hello everyone. Welcome to my YouTube channel. I'm Donald here, a first year student at KCA University, 2020 intake. Yeah, I'm doing Bachelor of Science in Information Technology. Yeah, in short, BSc IT. Yeah, and I'm currently the class representative for BSc IT KCA University 2020. Yeah, so I've been receiving various questions from new students, mostly those that have come late, those that have joined late due to various reasons. Yeah, they've joined after the orientation, so they've missed a lot. And also some from students that were there but just couldn't understand what was being taught. Okay, yeah, so what I've realized is that I've been receiving similar questions from students, and you have to like explain it over and over to various students. So that's what pushed me to starting this YouTube channel and creating tutorials for how you can navigate in the module, how you can navigate in the portal, and how you can create the two accounts. So that's what this video is majorly about. Yeah, so like I've said, I'm the class representative, so majority of the questions are directed to me, despite the fact that I have an assistant. Yeah, Joseph. Yes, so I just thought that creating this video will really help, and it also contains everything, so anyone can forward or rewind whatever they've not understood anything. So that's why this YouTube channel was created in the first place. So let's start. You'll first have to open a browser, of which Google Chrome is my browser of choice. Type KCA University. Don't need to complicate things with that, with ASU.KA. For those who don't understand that, KCA University, just type KCA University. Tap on this one. Pick on KCA University, a premium business and technology. There, it takes you directly to the school website. Okay, this is the school website. Actually, this is the home screen of the school website, and it also contains all the shortcuts and the links to the other various accounts in the university. You can see there's the library here, there's the the library, academics, various schools are here, remote engagement, the home where we are, the module link is here, the quick links to the various accounts, the portal, the distance learning, the e-learning login, all of them are here. There is also here where you get all the information updates from the university itself to the students. Like the other day, the vice chancellor said that we will be continuing with online studies in the September-December semester, despite the ministry's directive that universities should open on 5th October. Yeah, all that is here, as you can see. You just download it, it's in PDF, you can read. Yeah, our timetables are also down here. Yeah, so that's majorly, that's briefly about that. Then you go back to the home screen. Yeah, the home screen is let me just call it like a prospectus of the university. Can see, yeah, just introduces you to generally what KCA is all about, the various schools here, search for courses. Yeah, it's just an introduction to the university. So there's the module and the portal, student portal. Those are the main things about this YouTube video. Okay, so you are supposed to go through the student portal and the module account. So like I said, the website contains all the shortcuts to the various sites owned by the university. So our main concern here is the student portal and the module. So let's start with the student portal. The link to the student portal is up here. You go to the student portal. There's a there's an arrow beside the name. Sorry, there's an arrow beside the name. Just tap on it, and the drop down menu pops up. So yeah, you cannot see it from my recorded video screen, but you should be able to see it on yours. A drop down menu appears, which are quick links, student portal, contact us, lecturer login. Yeah, various links are in it. So just pick on the student portal because that's our main concern right now. Oh, the link here isn't working. But there's another link to the same. Another link to the same down here. If that one doesn't work, there's another one down here, student portal. Just tap on the student portal. So in the student portal, the first slot, you key in your admission number as your username. Under that slot is your password, of which your default password should be your ID number or your birth certificate registration number, depending on what you registered with. Various people have been complaining that I've used my ID number, it's saying password incorrect. So yeah, I've been advising them to use their birth certificate number, but at times both can refuse to work. Yeah, both can be jammed. So what I've been advising people is that they call the university or go there physically and get helped. Yeah, some have just given them numbers to people. I believe you should be able to help and they've been assisted. But to some, the case just persists, so you just have to visit the university physically. So in my case, I used my birth certificate, my ID number. I used my ID number. Then you sign in. So you see, like I said, the portal contains your personal information as a student. Contains your personal information as a student. Your admission number is here. Your full name is here. Your gender, your phone number, everything. Your fee balance, the fee you've paid. Like you, as you can see here, for this semester I've been charged 18,000. I paid a total of 24K. So my total balance in the university currently is -5,835. Meaning I overpaid. Yeah. So I said the portal contains your information as a student, including the name of your course, the units you've taken. So you there's a menu to the left of your screen, the top left of your screen, academics. You go under academics, and then course registration. It shows you your course. Like for me my particular course is Bachelor of Science in Information Technology. So you go to action. If you want to know the particular units you are taking, just tap on action, view units. Yeah, and there are my units. I have 6 units, the first one being computer application, 2 business communication, 3 operating systems, 4 computer organization and arc, 5 mathematics for sciences, and finally 6 information literacy and HIV/AIDS. Yeah, so that's all under academics concerning course registration. Then there is the coursework. From the coursework, you have the exam card, which you'll download as you get close to your exams. There's the exam audit, your exam results, everything. You'll find it in the portal here. There is the finance, fee balance, all that. Self-service, where you can now reset your password. Yeah, I remember your advice to use your ID numbers, your default password. So you can just come here and change it into your preferred characters. So that is all about the portal. So let's go to the module now. Let's now go to the module. Yeah, so the link to the module is just on the website. It's also just in the on the website on top here, like I showed you before. Tap on module. So for my case, I had already created a module account, as you can see, online e-learning portal. My username was my email. I used my email as my username, and then I also created my password, as you can see. So I saved everything under remember username. So anytime I just open my laptop and I want to access my module, I just come here, log in without even keying in my credentials. So for the new guys, if you don't have your module account yet, you cannot sign in and you don't have an account. So just come down here and tap on create new account. Create new account. So immediately you tap on create new account, this menu should appear. This menu should appear. So you'll give them a username, of which you advise to use your email as your username. Okay, use your email as your username. Then down here, your password, you key in your password, of which according to their specifications, your password should contain at least 8 characters, in which there must be numbers, there must be capital letters, there must be small letters, there must be signs, e.g. a hashtag or something like that. Yeah, so just think of something complex that you can put there. Then down here under more details, your email address. Yeah, just the same one you use as you used as your username, just key it in, your email address, sorry. And under that there is email again, the same email address you kept up here. Your first name, in my case it's Donald. My surname, it's Odor. Your city or town, Nairobi. Your country, Kenya. Yeah, you'll fill it according to your credentials. Yeah, your email, your surname, your first name, your town, your country. Then down here, additional student information, admission number, stroke staff number. So here you key in your admission number as it appeared in your calling letter. That is 20 stroke the number. Yeah, 20 stroke that is your admission number. Then faculty or school. The faculty is the general name where your course lies, like IT related courses such as BSIT, BSCIT, BBIT. All of those fall under Faculty of Computing and Information Management. Okay, so my faculty as an IT student, it is Faculty of Computing and Information Management. I pick on that. Then I go to my program. My program is now your particular course, the one you're sitting for. Mine is Bachelor of Science in Information Technology. You just look for your particular course under these ones. So it's Bachelor of Science in Information Technology, BSCIT. Then account status must always be kept on active. Campus registered to your campus, your particular campus. Yeah, in Kenya we have 6 campuses, six MKU campuses, six KCA campuses, sorry, where we have the main campus in Ruaraka, Nairobi, the town campus in Morovia Street, town Nairobi, Kitengela campus, Kisumu campus, Buruburu satellite campus, Amagoro satellite campus. Yeah, these are the 6 campuses in KCA, depending on which one you've been admitted to. Then down here, it's a security question. You just have to tap on that in the middle of the box, and then you're verified. Your next step will be to create new account. Okay, that's after you filled all these slots completely and you're sure they are totally filled. Okay, then you now tap on create my account. So your email address is very key. Your email address is very, very key. So you must make sure that the laptop you're using or the computer you're using, that email you have been filling up there, as your username, as the place they asked for your email, here, here and here. That email is logged into your computer. That email is logged into your computer, in that if someone sends you a text, you can be able to access it through that same computer. Yes, if someone sends your email. So on the module, on the creation of your module account, when you tap on create new account, a link will be sent to your email directly. Immediately you tap on it, a link is sent to your email. So you just have to like go through the email, open it, tap on the link. It's like a, let me say, it's a message of which the email is inside. Yeah, it's like hi, your number, your name, and so on. So then there's a link inside that message sent to you via email. So you tap on the link, and the link will take you directly back to the module, and you'll find a notification that your account has been successfully created. So you can now open your module account. Yes, so you see how key the email is and how key it is to have been logged in into your computer or your system, because it cannot be sent to your phone and then you like try activating your email, try activating your module through the phone and you are using the laptop. So you see it's complicated. So yeah, that's the form. Of course I couldn't have filled it completely because I've not got a default account of a student who hasn't created any yet. Most of them have been creating and they have errors. Some have issues of what should I say? Let me just use secrecy, as in you don't want your credentials to leak out. Yeah. For privacy. Okay, so that's all about creation of the module account. So as for me, since I already have an account, I'm just going to tap on login, because my email is there, as my username, my password is there. Yeah, so I just log in to the module. So here is the module. This is the module itself. First, you'll just see like an advert here. This is the home screen of the module. An advert saying School of Business and Public Management, who we are. Yeah. Then there's a search box directly under the advert. And then if you're just creating your module account for the first time, it's the first time you're creating your module account, these ones won't be there. These are the courses I've already enrolled for. So we have just been from the portal right now, and I've showed you where you can see your units, the units you've been registered for. So you see, registration is done by the university itself. After you paid your school fees, they register for you the unit you're supposed to be taking. But then it's upon you to go to the module and enroll for those particular units. Okay, you go to the module and enroll for those particular units, but they are already registered for you in the university via the portal. You can see that in the portal. So registration is done by the university, enrollment is done by the student themselves. Okay, so I need to show you how you enroll for units. Yeah, so as you can see, I've already enrolled for my units by myself, of which as an IT student this semester, first year student this semester, my first semester I had 6 units, which are mathematics for science, operating systems, business communication skills, fundamentals of computer systems, HIV and AIDS, information literacy, and there's another which hasn't been activated yet called computer applications. Okay. Yeah, so I need to show you how you enroll for a unit. So let's pick on Let's speak on operating systems. Oh, and then one thing you must know is the particular lecturer taking you for a particular unit. You need to know the full name of the unit. You need to know the unit codes of the unit. You also need to know your lecturer. You need to know your particular lecturer, okay? You need to know your particular lecturer. So that by the time you'll be enrolling, you just search for the unit name, using the unit name itself or using the unit code, and then you go straight to the particular unit with the particular lecturer. Because you might find that in KCA, that same unit is being taught by so many lecturers, and there is a particular lecturer assigned to you. Yeah, there's a particular lecturer assigned to you, and there's no way you can just change it yourself and then you're like, I'm being taught by another lecturer, and in your system it shows you're being taught by this particular lecturer. So here, operating systems as IT students, BSc IT students, are being taken through that by Madam Juliet Njiru. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to enroll from this particular unit and then take you through how you enroll for a unit. So let me just open it. And then I unenroll, as in I totally remove it from my list. Continue. I believe you've followed the steps, so that in case you find yourself you've enrolled into a wrong unit, you're able to unenroll and enroll to the correct one. So here I want to now enroll for the particular unit operating systems, right? The operating systems, the one I've just removed from my list of courses. So I just come here, type operating systems, then tap on go. So you see, I have 33 search results. Yeah, I have 33 search results as operating systems. You see, that same unit is being taught to diploma in information technology students, is being taught to special and supplementary examinations. They are there for operating systems. It's also operating systems being taught by Madam Gladys Mange. You see, and you know your particular lecturer. Your particular lecturer is Madam Juliet Wawira Njiru. So, you can see here, computer operating systems being taught by Madam Juliet Njiru, but it is for semester category, for category trimester 4. And you're looking for Madam Juliet Njiru semester 1. Yeah, trimester 1. So just look for your operating systems and your particular course. So let's look for operating system Bachelor of Information Technology. Yeah, let's check on this one. Yeah, you see, this one isn't working. You cannot enroll yourself in this. So various students have been having issues finding that particular unit. And there's another one down here, Bachelor of Science in Information Technology. You can see Madam Juliet Njiru, the one we're looking for in operating systems, is also taking Bachelor of Science in Software Development students for that same unit. So you see how important it is to know your particular lecturer and the particular unit they're taking you through. So down here you found operating systems by Madam Juliet Njiru, under which category? Bachelor of Science in Information Technology. This should be my unit now, okay? So operating systems, tap on it. Enrollment options, operating systems. Yeah, So as you can see, I cannot enroll into this one directly. It requires an enrollment key. So what is an enrollment key? Yeah, various students have been asking that. Okay, enrollment key. Let me say, you are trying to enroll for a unit, and then you are required to like use a particular key. Let me just call it a password for you to be able to see what the lecturer has posted into it. And you can get that through your WhatsApp groups. As in, when the lecturer gets the enrollment key, they will send it to either the group leader or send it to the group itself, so that the students can be able to access the unit. So for operating systems, Madam Juliet Njiru had already given us an enrollment key, which was BIT 1106A@OS. So you type in your enrollment key inside the box, and then you tap on enroll me. See, so it takes you directly into the unit itself, and you're able to see what the lecturer has posted. Like you can see, I have a notification here, you are enrolled in the course. So anytime you enroll into a unit, an email is sent to your email account immediately. An email is sent to your email account immediately as a confirmation that you've enrolled for that particular unit. So right now it's on we're on 4th October. Yeah, last week, meaning last month, Madam Juliet had given us a group exercise which we're supposed to do. So she sent it to the module, and students were able to download and do it. Now you can see under announcements, there is group exercise one, the one we did last week. So just tap on it. Yeah, all the notes will always be posted in the module by the lecturer. They are in PDF format, as you can see. There is the course outline, there is topic one, introduction topic, the notes are there. It's in PDF format, you download. So here she had sent us an exercise, and she kept it under announcements. So just tap on the exercise itself. So as you can see, I can already see the exercise. My computer is lagging. Yeah, you can see that's the exercise she had given. You can see question one, question two, question three. I've been able to enroll for the unit, used the enrollment key, and seen what has been posted for me in the module. So you're currently in the module, and then it's like every time you want to see this thing, you go to the module to see it. So just download it into your computer. So you bring your cursor to the top of the document. Just bring your cursor to the top of the document, then a drop down menu will appear. Then you tap on the download icon, and it automatically starts downloading. Gives you an option of saving exercise one. I can save it, save. Yeah, so it automatically starts downloading, as you can see, and it goes to your downloads. So you can go there later and arrange your documents according to how you want them to be arranged. Yeah, like for me, I've created particular folders for particular units. Like this unit has its own folder, all the notes you are sent, I have downloaded them and kept them in that particular folder, so that anytime I want to read, I can just read online. It's not a must I go back to the module to see what has been posted. Yeah, so I have taken you through the operating systems. So let's also go through there. Yeah, that's operating systems is an example of a unit that required an enrollment key, but there are some which hadn't been activated yet. So students were just enrolling for the units without enrollment keys. You just go in directly without an enrollment key, and you see what had been posted. An example of those was the Fundamental of Computer Systems by Madam Gladys Mangi. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to unenroll for it. then I enroll back into it so that you can see how direct this one is. Now that it doesn't require an enrollment key, but she said she's going to work on it. Fundamentals of computer systems. So I just go to that box, type fundamentals of computer systems. Yes, then tap on go. And then I know my particular lecturer. You see, that same unit, that very unit is being taught by Mr. Collins Ondiek to Bachelor of Business Information Technology students. Yeah, you see that this is why it is so important for you to know your lecturer and your course. Yeah, so like here you've already found our search result, Fundamentals of Computer Systems BSc IT, Madam Gladys Mange. You tap on Fundamentals of Computer Systems, enrollment options. So you see it says no enrollment key required, so you just go into it directly. Okay, self-enrollment student, enroll me. So I'm already enrolled into the unit without using an enrollment key directly, and I can already see what she had posted. Yeah, here is the course overview, a PDF file of generally what the course is all about. There is lesson 2 notes. There is lesson 3 notes, computer software, lesson 4 file management, lesson 5 operating systems. These are notes. Lesson 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. All of those are here. Fault diagnosis, preventive maintenance, all those. So you're just supposed to tap on the file, download it, and you're able to see it offline. You see? So for those students who are just joining right now, you've been asking for notes, how do we get them? So this is how you get the notes. Just open your Moodle account, enroll for the units, and ask for the enrollment keys from your particular subject representative or the lecturers, comma, they hadn't been sent, and download your notes. Yeah, it's that simple. So We've already covered mathematics for sciences. I had already done that on my own earlier. Operating systems we've done here. Bachelor of Communication Skills I had already done. Fundamentals of Computer Systems we've done here. HIV and AIDS and Information Literacy I had already done it prior. So then there was another question. HIV and AIDS Information Literacy. Let me unenroll for it and enroll, then enroll back into it. Continue. So I have unenrolled myself for that particular unit. So you see, it's off my list. So what I do is I go to my timetable. You see, we have been searching for units using their particular unit names. You can also search for a unit using the particular unit code. So for this one, let's try using the code. Obviously, the code for that particular unit was BIT. And you write it exactly how it appears on the timetable. BIT 1111. Tap on go. You see? For us, IT BSc IT students, the teacher taking us, you know, see, those are two, the unit HIV and AIDS and Information Literacy, it is taught in two phases. There is the HIV and AIDS part, and there's the Information Literacy part. So we are being taught by Madam Anne Masharia and Mr. Benjamin Mutungi. So Madam Anne Masharia takes us through the HIV and AIDS part, and Mr. Benjamin Mutungi takes us for Information Literacy. So I've searched for the course, I'm into it, the unit, I'm into it, and I can already see my lecturers here. So this is what I'm going to pick on. As you can also see, it's already Bachelor of Science in Information Technology, so I'm going to tap on it, the unit itself, and then you see. So this one requires an enrollment key. of which we had already been given. I'll just key it in right now. So you look here, it's written home courses, KCA University, Western Campus, Kisumu, undergraduate programs. Yeah, Western Campus, Kisumu. So many students have been asking me, I have tried looking for the unit, and then I get there, it is written Western Campus, Kisumu, and that's not my campus. So I feel like it's the wrong unit. So the student leaves the unit here, goes back searching for another particular one. Yeah, so you understand how the complication comes in. So what I believe is that during this remote engagement during COVID-19, lecturers from all over, as in KCA countrywide, are teaching the students as a team. Okay, so like me personally, I was admitted to KCA University main campus, Ruaraka in Nairobi. But I'm also being taught by lecturers from Kisumu. As in, all the KCA students are now being taught by one team of lecturers. So here it says KCA Western Campus, and here are the lecturers. So I'm posted at Nairobi, but I'm being taught by lecturers who are posted in Kisumu. So if you see this, don't freak out. It's just correct. As in, your lecturer is posted there, but he's also teaching you. It's just working. It's fine. So we were sent the enrollment key prior. And the enrollment key for this particular unit was HIT. HIT 320. And then you enroll yourself. So as you can see, I'm already into the unit. I can see what has been posted. And here are the notes. So the notes can either be in Word format or PDF format. In this case, the notes are in Word format. So Introduction to Information Literacy. This is in Word format. You see, at times when you tap on a particular folder in module, it downloads itself automatically and goes into your system. Like the minute I tapped on that one, it was downloaded automatically, as you can see down here. So I can go and look at it offline. So once you open a particular note, there is an arrow to this side. Like, let me say that note was among other notes. Okay, so there's a note that was before that one, and there was a note that was after that one. So you can tap on an arrow facing to the left that goes to takes you automatically to the previous note, and then the arrow pointing to the right taking you to the next note. So immediately you press on, like, let me just try the right arrow, it takes you to the next one. You see, the next one is also already downloading automatically. Yeah, so you'll be able to see those notes offline. This takes me back to introduction. So anytime you scroll on something in the module, it downloads itself automatically. So I have downloaded this one twice already. So I now go back to the other one. This is now the first one. The first one, nothing has been posted, as you can see. So yeah, that was the unit generally. We've used the enrollment key. We also searched it using the unit code. So I believe this answers all your questions concerning the module. I have tried to be as comprehensive as possible. Oh yeah, there's another thing I need to teach you. There's another thing. Let me go to my home. So this is the home screen of the module. I have registered for 5 units. They're supposed to be 6. The 6th one is supposed to be computer applications, which is not yet ready. It hasn't been activated yet. Let me just search for it so that you get a confirmation for those who had doubts. So the unit code was BIT 1102 M. Press and go. So you see, the unit appears, and my particular teacher is Madam Grandis Mange. So my course is full time. It's a full time course. So I go to computer applications full time. Bachelor of Science in Information Technology. Tap on that. As you can see, you cannot enroll yourself for this course. It's not yet ready, it hasn't been activated. So that's a confirmation to those students who had doubts. Yes, you see, none of them is working. That's as of now, on 4th October, the unit was not yet activated. So yeah, we're back to the home screen of the module. You can see that the units I have enrolled for. Yes. So that was basically all about the module, and yeah, this is where my video ends. Yes. Yeah, we were just supposed to cover the portal. We were supposed to cover the portal and the module. So I believe this video will be of help to all those having issues with the two accounts. Yes. If you have any questions, something you've not understood, or something that is totally going wrong on your side, and you need some help, you can contact me. And then I can give you contacts to people in KCA that I believe can be able to help you. Or you can just go to the university physically. You can just visit the university buildings physically. Yeah, so yeah, this YouTube channel was majorly about this, but I'm planning to expand it into something else. Like soon we will start doing exams soon. Yes, we will start doing assignments and submitting them on the module soon. So I'm planning to create tutorials for the same. Yes. Yes, and the channel is not also all about modules and KCA. It can also be for modules in other universities. Like I've also interacted with the module of MKU University. And trust me, as KCA University, we have the best online platform system I've seen so far. I've seen the one for the University of Nairobi. I've seen the one for Chuka University. I've seen the one for KCA University and MKU. Yeah, I've seen those ones. And trust me, what I've noticed is that KCA is the best. So you are lucky to be a KCA student right now. You're lucky for that. And then some have been asking me at you, what is Zoom? Okay, so Zoom is the platform for learning for those students who have not attended any classes up to now. Zoom is the platform for learning. As in, when the teacher wants to meet you, they will send you a link to the meeting. That's actually the platform KCA is using. Different universities are using different platforms, like the University of Nairobi is using Zoom also. Chuka University is using Microsoft Teams. MKU is using Microsoft Teams, which I consider very complex, and not so many students will understand how to use them. But as KCA, we are using Zoom, which is very simple. So our teachers send links to various Zoom meetings, which are sent to the WhatsApp groups, or the class representative usually has it. So you look at your timetable, you check on your timetable. You see the particular unit you're supposed to be taking the time, then wait for the meeting link, and then you're just going to join it. It's a virtual class. It's so interactive. In fact, I can say virtual classes are better than face-to-face learning, because virtual classes are very interactive. You are free to ask your lecturer a question. You are answered freely. Actually, some lecturers are very generous. In fact, let me personally appreciate Madam Gladys. She's always free with students. Yeah, and other lecturers also, but Madam Gladys is the most outstanding so far. Yeah, you're free to ask questions. That's why I'm saying virtual learning is just the best. It's just better than the rest. Yeah, so that's how. So Zoom is the platform for the lesson. But if there are notes to be sent, assignments to be sent, exams to be done, that will be sent to the module. So that's why the module is very, very important. Yeah. Okay, that's where my channel, my video ends. Thank you for watching. If you liked the video, please press on the like button and subscribe. You can also comment down on the comment section and share the video. Share the video to all other students you believe have issues with their modules and portals, because I've tried making the video as comprehensive as possible, so it should be able to help each and every new student in KCA or an old student having some issues with the portal, okay, and the module. So thank you. Yeah, that was Donald and that was my time. So please like and subscribe and share the video. Thank you. See you in the next video. I walk around like that nigga. Nigga on the trigger. If I need to lose, I smoke, I let it drop.